Welcome to Democratically Speaking. My name is Mark Linde. I'm your host, and I'm also the chairman of the Brockton Democratic City Committee, and I'm doing this show in my capacity as a volunteer. I'm not doing it on work time. I have a good, loyal Democrat in Ward 7, Tim Sullivan. Welcome, Tim.
Glad to be here.
Good to see you. Tim served previously as the school committee member from Ward 7 2 years ago,
and I did it for 2 terms.
2 years.
Two elected terms.
And you took a chance, you rolled the dice, and you ran for city council, and it didn't work.
I did pretty good in the primary. I won.
Mm-hmm.
And then I got sick, and I couldn't go door to door, and I lost a lot of support. And I lost.
But you were here. I got to give you credit. You were here, even though you were sick, and you did a debate, and I think you were on medication at the time. Okay, and it was tough, but you showed up. We postponed it because you were sick, but you look great. You took off some weight. You're raring to go and roll up your sleeves and get back into the game, right?
Right, and I'm just full of strength, and like I was telling the girl here earlier, Tuesday nights, I have nothing to do.
Mm-hmm.
I want to get back into it. I loved it.
Well, school committee is a serious commitment. School committee, you guys have more subcommittee meetings and PAC and PTO meetings, and school events. School committee members work really hard.
Yes, I know.
Okay. When you were on before, what subcommittees were you on?
I was on the bid review committee. I was the chairman of that. I was on the contract negotiation committee. I wasn't the chairman, but I was on the committee. I did the administrative assistants, the lunch girls, the school police, and there was another one too, the MTAs.
There's lots of unions within the school system, okay? You get the big one, the BEA, the teachers union, but you're talking all the other ones. And can I tell you something? The lunch ladies, the custodians, the administrative assistants, I'm going to say that they run the place, okay? You got great faculty and administration and staff, but you got great, the behind-the-scenes workers, those are the unsung heroes.
And I just want to add, Mark, that they have to live in Brockton.
Mm-hmm.
The school teachers don't, but everybody else does.
Right.
So these are our Brockton people.
Mm-hmm. So you were in it. Like I said, you rolled the dice to go to the next level, if you will, the city side. And now you want to get back in it. Why do you want to get back in it?
I feel that the person there today is not doing a good job. I was at a PTA meeting, I'm going to say about 2 months ago.
Mm-hmm.
And I found out from the treasurer of the PTA that the last time Ray Hennington had been there was 2 years ago when I brought him in to introduce him. And I was kind of upset that the Raymond School had knocked off 6th, 7th, and 8th grades. And nobody knew about it. So I'm coming back so stuff like that does not happen. I'm going to see if I can straighten it out.
Okay. Issues that are different or similar to when you were there. I know the city is contemplating. This is where ed reform started in Brockton, if you go way back.
Right.
To, I think it was Webby versus Board of Education. Ernie Webby, the former library director, was Hancock, it was McDuffie. It's had a whole bunch of names. I don't know what the next name is going to be. But Brockton doesn't feel that it's being funded properly. And then you have towns that don't feel like they're being funded properly. So the state is getting ready to look at ed reform all over again. And now we have a different governor in there. We went from a Deval Patrick to a Charlie Baker, changed parties. It's Republican now. You get a different Board of Education. We had our former superintendent as the Secretary of Education. Now there's a different one. Do you think that's a good idea? Do you think that's a good path to go down and sue the state?
Yes, I do. My theory is, if we're not trying to sue the state for money, we're trying to sue the state to change their formula in the dates. In other words, October 1st, our actual total of kids has got to be submitted to the state to get the Chapter 70 money. And it seems like from October 1st to the first of the year, we're inundated with students. that we have no money for. The state will not give us a dime for that. So we're trying to change it. So December 31st is the cutoff date rather than October 1st. And as you know, the amount of students just keep on creeping up. When I was there, we were at 14.5, and it snuck up almost to 15. It didn't hit 15. Now we're over 17,
mm-hmm.
2 years later. So we're picking up about 1,000 students per year, which is a lot of money.
Any issues? The schools in Ward 7, correct me if I'm wrong, Raymond you mentioned, North Middle School is in 7, the George School
correct.
Is in 7. Am I missing any?
The Howard.
Okay, the
still there, but it's not running as a school.
That's right. Okay, and with the north-south zone, kids from Ward 7 don't necessarily stay in Ward 7 particularly because they might be in one of the language immersion programs or they could be in a different special ed program. So they're not just there. So you run the gamut from K, and the high school isn't physically located in Ward 7, but there's a bunch of kids that go to Brockton High from there. So what's new, what's different? What do you want to get involved with? What do you want to do differently or similarly to when you were there before?
Well, number one, at the Raymond, I'd like to see it go back to K-8 rather than K-5. And the reason being, it was a community school. Kids in the neighborhood could walk to school, and the older ones walked with the younger ones. And the parents didn't have to worry about it. Now, they're being bused all over the place. They could be anywhere right now.
Mm-hmm.
It could be the younger kids on the bus, or it could be the older kids, but they're not walking together like they were. I'd like to see that get straightened out. And the issue at the Howard School was they had radon issues in the cellar, and nobody could go into the cellar, including the custodian.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, there was a bathroom there, a shower there, and he couldn't use it. Radon somehow was leaking into the building, and now I'm hearing that it could be fixed. There is a way to fix that. I'm not sure if there is or not. But that's part of the reason why that school closed, and they moved down to the...
George School?
No, they went down to Ward 4.
Oh, Gilmore.
The Gilmore School.
Okay.
All those kids went on the first floor, and then the nurses all went to the second
floor. Because that was like the early education program and part of that school,
correct.
If I remember right. So... you must be out. I know I've seen you out holding signs. You've been knocking on doors?
Yes, I have.
And what are you hearing from people out in the ward when you're going out? I'm looking at the signs. Everybody's got signs up. There's more signs per square inch. They're all gonna turn into Halloween missiles, unfortunately.
That's what I'm afraid of.
What are you hearing from former constituents or future constituents?
I'm hearing a lot of positive. In other words, the people are real glad I'm coming back, and they missed me. And to be honest, I'm glad I'm coming back. I'm going to see if I can straighten a few things out. And they just don't like the job that's being done now. They feel like they're being neglected and not told what's going on in the Brockton Public Schools.
Communication, what would you do, being on the school committee again, to communicate to your constituents? You got any ideas?
Yes, I do. I had, I used to be known as the person who always called back for anything. I was getting calls for streets being paved, fences knocked down, branches, leaves blown in the yards, gates not open.
Not a school committee member's responsibilities, by the way.
Right. This was, it seemed like I was getting everything.
Mm-hmm.
But I was the only one that was taking care of things. And I'd stay on it until it was done. And I'd call the people back and say, your problem, whatever it was, has been fixed. And they were happy. And I'd like to keep doing that. You know, my number's in the phone book. Give me a call, anything. You know, if you have trouble with your trash is not picked up, the bus stop is wrong for the kids.
So you'll just get that info and you'll pass it on to your city council or just do something about it?
No, I do it myself.
Okay. Now let me talk about your background. Okay, you have an interesting background. Okay, I've known you for a while.
Yes,
you My wife knows you.
Yes.
You helped her out at one point when she was stranded. BAT, Brockton Area Transit, right?
Correct.
Okay. How long have you been doing that?
I've been at BAT for over 30 years. And we had talked earlier, and I feel like that's a public service job. I'm dealing with the public all the time, and I like it. You have to have the right personality for something like that, and I think I have it.
30 years is a long time to be in a job. People go through jobs like they go through clothes sometimes, if you really think about it. Now, another hat that I know of is Brockton Housing Authority. You've been involved in that for a while.
Yes, I was appointed by the mayor, 1999, to go on as the labor person of Brockton Housing. And I've been there ever since. So I've been through, I'm going to say four mayors since I've been there. In 2007, I was appointed, I was elected the chairman, and I have been ever since. Two of those years, I was the treasurer. We had a budget at Brockton Housing of $1 million a month, not counting the salaries for the workers, and there's over 100 workers. And I was proud. I was proud to balance that budget and keep it going, and that's still going good today.
Besides that, you're involved in other things. What else?
I'm the former president, business agent of my union at work, which is the ATU Local 1547. And I had given that up and just decided to get out of it completely. And I got dragged back in. A new guy was going to go in as president and wanted me to come along as vice president, which I did. And we just successfully negotiated a contract for 3.5 years with the bus drivers and maintenance people in Brockton.
Does that help you, being a union guy, when you're on the school committee and you're sitting on the other side of the table negotiating as management?
Yes, it does. It gives me, I think it gives me a better insight to know how they're thinking. And I just jump on it first before they know what happens. I feel like I'm good at it.
Community service, you already took. We got the bus, got the BHA, the union is job related, okay? Anything else? Am I missing something?
This particular year, I'm the president of the DW Field Park Association. And I know you're up there. We had a big fundraiser, which was Tower Fest, October 10th. And we raised about $5,000. We did pretty good that day.
It's a nice day.
Beautiful day.
Good weather this year. It's been, some years it's been too cold or rainy, and some, but people still come out for it.
Well, last year we had to cancel.
Yeah.
And what happens is there is no rain date. You can't book everything. We have pony rides, pumpkins, face painting, magicians, rabbit shows, snake shows. And so you can't change them for the next day. You know, they're all doing something else. So there is no rain date. If we have a bad day, there is no Tower Fest. But most of the time, except for last year, all the time that I've been there about 5 years, and we've had a good day.
So how do you spend all that time doing it? You've been here a while. You got children in Brockton and grandchildren, too?
Children in Brockton. I've moved to Brockton, as I said, in 1972, and I've been here ever since. I have 5 children, 11 grandchildren. Every one of them go to Brockton Public Schools, or they used to. My kids are grown up now, and they have kids. And I like it here. I like Brockton.
What entered your mind originally when you served your last 2 terms to run? Why did you decide to run for office and be an elected official? You're an appointed official. You got elected by your peers to be chairman of that group. Same with the union. What prompted you to get involved?
There was something, some kind of drive in me that I just wanted to give it a try. I thought I'd be good at it. I wanted to get into an elected position and just feel it out. And I think it worked. You know, people were happy. I'd get letters all the time. I get phone calls saying what a good job it is, who I was doing. And I wasn't even sure people knew. You know, the school committee, as you know, was on TV. But I don't know who watches it.
I know when I'm on TV, people comment. Usually, they'll either comment good or bad, okay? I think it's important to put government on TV so people can see it.
Oh, I agree.
Not everybody comes. What's your favorite part? What's the thing you like the most? What you get? I know school committee members do not get paid the same way a city council gets paid. You get it like a stipend. It's not a lot of money. You're not doing it for the money.
No.
But what's what do you get out of it?
You get satisfaction. It's a job that has to be done, and I love doing it. Mm-hmm. You know, I had a ball.
Okay. So round two. You get a bunch of notes. Tell me what I haven't gotten to that you want to talk about, because we have a good 10 minutes left to go, at least.
The notes are what you didn't mention. I'm on the Democratic City Committee as well.
Mm-hmm.
I was the chair of my ward twice. I was a treasurer once. I was a delegate to the convention twice. My schooling, I went to the George Meany Labor Center in Silver Springs, Maryland. I also went to the Quincy Labor Guild in Quincy. I belong to the Plymouth County Democratic League, the BHA, since 1999, chair since 2006, and the treasurer of the BHA for 2 years. That's all the notes I have.
Well, I want to go back to the labor thing, okay? George Meany, now that's a name I remember. I remember he used to do a Labor Day address on radio, on Labor Day, I believe it was.
It was.
Okay. And I always thought the name was funny, the last name, Meany. I actually know someone from Bridgewater with that same last name. Great guy who used to work at Bridgewater State. So the whole negotiation process that you go through, okay, obviously you can't talk much about it because you can't give out the private behind-the-scenes stuff. I'm on a school committee, too, so I understand that. Mm-hmm. And the committee that I deliberately didn't want to be on was anything to do with the union. Because I'm an MTA member at Massasoit, it's AFT, so it's not MTA, so there wasn't any conflict. I got a ruling on that. But I ended up on the committee when we had someone who was sick. But I think you learn a lot out of the labor movement. If you think about labor in this country going back to, we didn't have 8-hour days. We didn't have overtime, right?
Saturday and Sunday was a regular day.
You don't have a management position at the bus company. You're a driver.
I'm a driver.
You're a blue-collar worker. Okay? So it probably makes the process easier because it doesn't have to be adversarial when you're negotiating a contract.
No,
right?
It doesn't. In fact, it's just the other way. It's almost better off not being adversarial and get more things done.
Mm-hmm. Now, how does your family feel about your public service? Because public service takes a lot of time away from family.
It does. And my wife says if I'm happy, she's happy.
Okay. That's good.
So we both seem to click that way. I don't have to tell her where I'm going. I put the suit and tie on and just go to the school committee meeting.
Now, it's not just going to the school committee meeting, like we were talking about before. There's a lot of school activities that happen.
Yeah.
There's, I know school committee members, I think you like sports, am I right?
Yes, I do.
So are you a boxer fan?
Yes, I am.
And any particular sport in particular, or do you kind of graze and go to all of them?
I kind of graze and go to all of them, but I do like football, maybe a little bit more.
Okay.
And I used to like going to those games, Thanksgiving Day. We had a ball.
So you had some health issues, and that affected the last election.
And they're all cleared up now.
And they're all cleared up now, so you get the energy.
Energy's back. I'm feeling gung-ho. I like this job. I want it back, and I want to do it well for everybody.
What kind of support do you think you're getting out there? You said positive response?
Yes. I'm trying to hit every door in Ward 7. I don't know if I'm going to make it, as we only have a week left.
Mm-hmm.
And I am working full-time right now. So there's 8 hours a day, and now we're going to change our clocks this week.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to be out there in the dark pretty soon.
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying. I'm going to try to get to the door, but my number's in the phone book. If everybody wants to call.
You can tell them the number. Go for it.
My telephone number is 508-586-3848. Just give me a call.
Because they can't call you on a cell phone if you're driving a bus. That's a bad idea, right?
I'll lose my job.
You don't want to do that. Okay. So what about the testing? You were on the school committee before, and MCAS was the standard.
Correct.
Mass Comprehensive Assessment System. I always say that's plural because I believe there should be more to it than just a single test. But now you're hearing, you got all these acronyms coming out. You got PARC, you got Common Core. Who know, what do you feel about standardized testing? Good or bad, pro or con, necessary? Do we teach too much to the test? That's an issue you'll weigh in on as a school committee member, as you know.
Yeah, well, to be honest, MCAS, I think, is the way to go. This PARC doesn't seem to be working as well as the MCAS did. And I'm well aware the teachers were teaching just to the MCAS. In other words, they knew the test was coming up, and they start cramming just to pass the test, which that isn't fair either.
Mm-hmm.
You know, these kids today are going to be our leaders of tomorrow. Let's give them a chance and teach them more. And I'd like to see them go back to the MCAS.
Okay. What about the class sizes, the budget and everything like that? I know during the debate with your opponent, you talked about that. What are your thoughts on it?
My thoughts are the class sizes should be 25 to 27 students per class. I'm well aware we have, at one time, we had 54 teachers laid off. Some of them will come back. But it hurts even to have one teacher laid off. We need them. We need them in place. The MTAs are laid off as well. Those are the monitors and the teacher assistants. All those people laid off should be brought back to work. We have 24 schools in Brockton that are open and three that aren't. I'm not even sure what's going on with the three. I know there's one up on off of Belmont Street.
Mm-hmm.
I think somebody bought it now. The
yellow Whitman School?
Yes, the Whitman.
Gifford and Belmont.
Yeah.
Right near Dairy Queen. That's where I went to elementary school. Three of my years.
You date yourself, Mark.
I know. My mother taught there. That was her last teaching assignment. She was at the Whitman School. I loved the Whitman School.
It's beautiful.
It was a neighborhood school, which kind of brings me back. I don't want to interrupt your train of thought, but we're talking walking to school. We entered a voluntary desegregation program to balance the schools out. That's how we got the 90% reimbursement to build the schools. Mm-hmm. But transportation costs are huge, and they're not completely reimbursed. I know we do this with Southeastern Regional, and you drive a public bus, but the private buses, they cost money to run too. And it says subject to appropriation in the bill. So we don't get full regional transportation. We get more than Brockton does, but we don't get enough. Do you think return to the neighborhood schools would help that?
In fact, I do, Mark. I'm glad you brought that up. What I wanted to do was also look at the issues that have been privatized. Busing is one of them. And just look at it. Make sure that what started to happen is still happening, that the city of Brockton is saving money by using school buses. I'd like to see either Bat Bus get involved with transporting some of these kids, or the school department do it on their own. They hire school bus drivers.
Mm-hmm.
I'm well aware that the first student now is making almost $8 million a year. It's a lot of money that the city has to come up with.
So you're looking to bring some of your expertise
I'm going to
in
try
that area.
Bring that in and see if I can straighten it out a little bit.
Well, I know at Southeastern, we own our own buses. We run our own company. We've actually looked into hiring it out. It's more cost effective to keep it in. And we also rent out. Sometimes people hire our buses versus a First Student or something like that because they're a little more cost effective. But I'm trying to think what else we haven't gone over. There's been...
Well, the lunch grills were privatized
right.
a few years ago.
And that seemed to have worked out
That seemed
well?
To be working.
Okay.
We still can take a look at it and see.
Okay.
To make sure that that seems to be the only department that really makes money now.
Mm-hmm.
And that was privatized. The grills still work for the City of Brockton.
Right.
But all the food comes from somebody else.
And I got to tell you, when you go to an event at the school, they sometimes host events, and Chartwell's kind of caters the event. They do a pretty good job.
It's not
it's not your institutional food like you would get in some places. See, I'm spoiled. We have culinary at Southeastern, and you do too. Brockton High mm-hmm. has it too. So we got about 3 minutes left. I'm going to give you a minute, 2 minutes to do like a little closing statement. Tell your potential constituents why Tim Sullivan. You can address them directly.
Good evening. My name is Tim Sullivan. I've lived in Ward 7 for about 12 years. I'm the former school committee person from Ward 7. I'd like to return to that job. I'm pretty sure I did a good job at it. I've heard no complaints from anybody. And I'd like to get it back again. I don't want to be negative. But I'm just not happy that the school committee person in Ward 7 today is doing the correct job for the people of Ward 7. And part of the reason is the closing of the Raymond School, not the closing, but knocking off the 6th, 7th, and 8th grades. It was about 3 years ago, 4 years ago. I fought like hell to keep that school open. The superintendent at the time, Matt Malone, wanted to close that school out of the clear blue sky. And I had to fight like hell just to keep that open. And now, here it is 3 years later, after spending over $1 million to fix the roofs, change the windows, add new doors, add some classrooms, that school used to be a community school, and it's not anymore. Those kids are being bused all over the City of Brockton. And that's part of my job. I want to see if I can straighten that out. The voting day is Tuesday, a week from today, Tuesday, November 3rd. The polls are going to be open from 7 in the morning till 8 o'clock at night. And I'd like to thank you in advance for your vote. Thank you.
Thank you, Tim. Thanks for being on Democratically Speaking.
Thank
Wish you well. And we will be here on election night. Every candidate that's running, welcome to come on TV or call in or whatever. We'll probably come by. I don't know where you're going to be that night. I know it's going to be a long day because I know that I've run myself, and you're out all day. It's a long day. But
I'm hoping for a good day that day, too.
Oh, yeah. Let's hope we get good weather. Weather is an issue. We got the city election,
the
school committee. We have a state senate race. And as soon as that election's over, we'll be on to the next election.
It's coming quick.
Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
And thank you for joining us as viewers on Democratically Speaking. Make sure on Tuesday, November 3rd, you get out and do your civic duty, go to the polls and vote. It only takes a couple of minutes. Thank you for joining us.